Our next guest says he is here to help retail investors, ones who want to go beyond traditional stocks and bonds. Ed Iglesias is right beside me here, manages more than $8.5 billion. He is head of alternative investments for Direction Funds. He has invested in commodities, managed futures, and currencies. Ed, thanks for coming in to talk to us here on Money Moves. Welcome.
Thank you.
What are the advantages to investing in your funds? I mean, what does the average person get?
Well, they get daily liquidity, complete transparency, and highly regulated as well. The merits of alternatives, regardless of whether they're in a traditional alternative structure or in mutual funds or ETFs, is that they should have a low correlation to stocks and bonds.
Especially this year.
Yes, definitely helpful this year. The ability to profit in any economic environment, particularly in periods where equities underperform, where there's a higher interest rate environment. And contrary to what most people think when they hear alternatives, they think risk. That tends not to be the case. When you allocate a percentage of alternatives to a portfolio of stocks and bonds, they tend to mitigate the risk.
Well, anyone who's had a lot of money in the stock market this year can certainly identify with what you're saying. So instead, what are you focusing on? I mean, it sounds like currencies, commodities, some other asset classes out there.
We have a number of different alternatives available in a mutual fund structure. One is the Direction Currencies Trends Fund, and it's unique in that it replicates a long-short currency index. It enables an investor to get global currency exposure through 11 currencies and has the ability to profit whether the U.S. dollar is rising or falling.
Well, speaking of that, I mean, what's playing out in Europe is certainly affecting all kinds of products this year. So give me an example in the long short of exactly what's going on in your funds.
Well, the Currency Trend Strategy Fund is down a couple of percent for the year, but the index that we recently instituted within the fund is actually flat for the year and up this month.
Okay, so in other words, it's considering shorting the dollar and you're just looking at all these moving parts.
Yes, it's completely rules-based. It's a trend following approach. And right now I would say about half of the index is looking for the currency to rise against the dollar and about half the portfolio is looking for the currency to devalue against the dollar.
So a true hedge fund. Now, commodities as an alternative, I mean, we've seen prices go higher and higher. Just speaking with a trader at the CME in Chicago saying, you know, oil at $100 a barrel is a no-brainer and nowhere to go but up. I mean, how have you seen these funds, these elements perform for you this year?
Well, it's been difficult for a trend-following approach like managed futures or a long-short commodity strategy because we've had somewhat whipsawing or trendless markets. Historically, though, when you look at managed futures or a long-short commodity strategy, they've tended to perform well during bear markets in equities because you've had the ability to take advantage of some price movement, whether it's energies, metals, grains, et cetera.
Going forward, what do you see as the best strategies? Because to your point, we're wrapping up this incredibly volatile year. It's been hard to spot trends, which for a lot of funds provides difficulty. What do you think is going to be the best return for the average investor in the new year?
Well, I wish I had a crystal ball to answer that question. But really, to invest in different types of alternative investments, such as currencies, commodities, managed futures, because not only do they have a low correlation to stocks and bonds, but they have a low correlation to each other as well. So I would recommend for most clients to look at anywhere from a 10 to 30% allocation to different types of alternative strategies.
Ed, thanks so much for the time.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Ed Iglesias, Direction Funds, joining us here, $8.5 billion under management.